Messiah. Some even said he was the Son of God. He traveled the countryside with 12 main disciples, though others followed close behind. He would preach his truths to one person face to face, and then to 5,000 on a hillside. Woven into his teachings, there came more and more talk about his own death, first in masked terms, then ever more clearly. For centuries, a prophet who was anybody was bound to end up in the holy city of Jerusalem. The road to Jerusalem drew Jesus like a magnet. Entering the city is where we find him today. There is much excitement and enthusiasm. Adults want to touch his cloak and be near him. Children just want a chance to see him. Jesus is entering Jerusalem. Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Thank you.
Yes, there was great excitement as people came into the streets to see Jesus. As Jesus came into town on a donkey, the people waved palm branches and then laid them down in the road as he passed. Some laid down their coats. The whole city was disrupted. The authorities were not happy. The people who came out to see Jesus understood that he wasn't an ordinary visitor. However, they still didn't realize that his ministry in their city would eventually lead him to a death on a cross.
Now, shortly after Jesus arrived that day in Jerusalem, it was time to celebrate the festival of the Passover. Now, many people had traveled from far and near to come to the city of Jerusalem to do just that. The Passover was a special holiday. It was a fun day. It was a party that people celebrated with family and with friends. It was a party to remember the night long ago in Egypt when the angel of death passed over the houses of the Israelites. And therefore, the Israelites were able to leave slavery and go into the promised land. So Jesus gathered that night with all of his friends around a table for the Passover. He gathered with them, he got them all together, because he wanted one last time to eat a meal with them and to tell them how much he loved them. There was food at that meal, and there was wine.
Jesus would be tried for blasphemy. The room became very somber, and the disciples were distressed. They began to look at each other and say things like, "Surely it isn't me, Lord, is it? I can't be the one to betray my Lord." Who would be the betrayer of Jesus?
Thank you.
Questions about who would turn Jesus into his enemies, he finally announced that it would be the one who was dipping his hand in the bowl with him. It was going to be his friend and a fellow disciple. It was going to be Judas. Now everyone at the celebration was surprised, and maybe some were a little angry, maybe even mad that it had to happen. But someone had to be sure that God's plan was carried out. And Jesus knew in order for this to happen, he would need to be given over to the hands of the Roman authorities. Well, it was hard, as you can imagine. It was hard for people to continue to eat and to drink at the meal. And then, another surprise, as they were sitting around that table, Jesus took some bread. And he blessed it, and he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, and he said to them, "This bread is my body. Every time you eat from this bread, remember, I am always with you." And then, after the dinner was finished, Jesus picked up a cup, and he gave thanks to God, and he said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of your sins. And whenever you drink from this cup, remember, I am with you always."
We remember you. We remember you.
We remember you. By your sacrifice of blood, all glory now is due.
Is due
at this table here. Mercy hovers near.
Even today, right here in this room, we gather together to remember Jesus in the bread and in the wine of this simple meal that he gave us on the night of the Passover. And he invites everyone to come and eat.
Thank you.
Final night that Jesus gathered with his friends to eat the Passover meal, he not only gave them the gift of his body and blood, but he also gave them a new commandment. He told them that he had always loved them. He told them that he would always love them, and that nothing could stop that love from flowing forth. Then he said to them, "You too should love each other just as I have loved you." Disciples with him to the Garden of Gethsemane. For Jesus, this was a crossroads of his life and ministry, both figuratively and literally. Gethsemane was located at the edge of Jerusalem. It was a quiet place where one could think and pray. Gethsemane means olive press. There were many olive trees in this lush garden.
Wash with him.
when Jesus and his disciples got to the garden, he told them to sit and wait for him at the gate. He took two of the men with him, and he went into the garden to pray. He prayed, "Abba, Father, everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me. Yet not my will, but your will be done." Jesus didn't want to die, but he also knew his job was to do the will of God.
When you prayed beneath the trees, it was for me, O Lord. When you cried upon your knees, how could it be, O Lord? When in blood and sweat and tears, you dismissed your final fears, when you faced the soldier's fears, you stood for me. Triumph looked complete, it was for me, O Lord. When it seemed like your defeat, they could not see, O Lord. When you faced the mob alone, you were silent as a stone, and a tree became your throne. You came for me, O Lord.
It was in this garden that Jesus knew the time had come for him to die. When Jesus finished praying, he went back to the rest of his followers, and they were sleeping. This upset Jesus. He knew that the time of his death was coming, and he was disappointed that his friends couldn't even stay awake a few minutes while he was praying. Then they came. The soldiers came out with torches and swords to arrest Jesus as if he was a bandit. Jesus. They took him away. Judas did indeed betray Jesus with a kiss.
Thank you.
words took Jesus away. The disciples left in the garden were afraid. They were afraid for Jesus, and they were afraid for their own lives. They weren't really sure what would happen to them now that Jesus had been led away. If the mob was willing to arrest Jesus, what might happen to his followers? Would they be the next ones to be arrested? Even Jesus' good friends became reluctant to let others know that they knew him. The soldiers took Jesus to the high priest's house. His disciple Peter followed at a distance.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
No, she's right. You were there.
No, I already told you, I don't know that man, and I don't know what you're talking about.
You were there, I saw you. You're a Galilean.
No, I already said this. I don't know that man.
Peter, do you see what just happened? You just denied knowing Jesus, just like he told us you were going to. I wonder how he knew.
From soul denial was my pretext. His rescue was my goal. But after I denied him, time and time again, my eyes began to open. I saw how wrong I'd been. It wasn't for his rescue that I claimed him, not the reason for my action was fear of what men thought.
Stand up when I'm talking to you. That's better. They brought Jesus to me after they arrested him in that garden. I had him stand before me, just as you are now. I asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?" And he gave me a sarcastic answer. Something about that's what I said he was. So I asked him again who he claimed he was. And even though everyone was mocking and ridiculing him, this Jesus stood there and wouldn't answer me. Can you believe it? He wouldn't answer me, the governor. It was crazy. He seemed crazy. I was frustrated, a little bit amazed, to tell you the truth. The people just wanted him dead, and this man wouldn't say a single word to defend himself. So, I decided to do what I do every year at the Passover. I release one prisoner, let him go free. Makes me look pretty good, you know? So anyway, I hauled this Barabbas out of prison. He was a real character, dirtbag, murderer. I stood Barabbas beside Jesus and I asked the crowd, who they wanted released. And you know what they said? They said Barabbas. Can you believe it? I couldn't believe it. Now, you, look at me when I'm talking to you. Thank you. I'm Pilate. The people wanted this murderer to go free. Instead of this meek little man named Jesus. So, I did what they wanted. I released Barabbas. Then I asked the people what they wanted me to do with this Jesus. And they yelled, "Crucify him." They told me they wanted me to kill him using a Barabbas form of capital punishment. Hang some up on a post for days until they die. It's humiliating and it's ugly. Sometimes we use a cross, that's what we did with Jesus. The soldiers have to hammer nails through their hands and through their feet to hold them up to the post. The person hanging there, they die by suffocation. Sometimes we hang them upside down while the blood rushes to their head. Do you hear me? I said they suffocate because the way they hang collapses their lungs. It's not a pretty story, but remember, you're the ones who came to me. So I'm telling you just the way it was. Don't you understand? I had no choice. I had Jesus flogging. Everybody loves a good flogging, you know. Then I turned him over to the people for them to crucify him. I washed my hands of the whole situation. I wanted nothing more to do with it. Don't you understand? I had no choice. Now, go away. Leave me alone. I'm Pilate, the governor. I don't have time for this choir and you children.
Jesus.
the dove was wounded. A crown of thorns was placed upon his head, and he suffered and he bled. Our tears flow with anguish and with shameful dread. Jesus died on a cross. The Lamb of God, the Word made flesh, the Savior of the world, was hung on a cross to die. Now, to be sure that he was dead, the soldiers pierced his side with a sword. People had come to the hill called Golgotha to witness his death. People mocked Jesus that day on the cross. People asked him to come down and to save himself if he was really a king. Eventually, the soldiers cast coins for Jesus' clothing. It was indeed a sad day. Death brings sadness into our hearts. Our hope on this day, the day of Jesus' crucifixion, is that he truly did love each one of us.
Jerusalem. He celebrated the Passover with his friends. It was an exciting time. But now we have seen his life violently taken from him. Jesus was killed because his accusers believed he blasphemed God. His disciples have fled in fear. Just before sundown on the day of his death, a secret follower of Jesus named Joseph, who lived in Arimathea, got permission to remove Jesus' body from the cross and took it to his own tomb for burial. It was a very hurried affair, for the sun was about to set and Jewish law forbid work to be done on the Sabbath day.
My
Just leave me alone.